Om Namah Shivaya. Hi friends, how are you? In this video we are going to learn about oxygen hemoglobin dissociation curve. Oxygen hemoglobin equilibrium curve, dissociation or association curve explains the relationship between the partial pressure of oxygen in blood with oxygen saturation of hemoglobin. Oxyhemoglobin equilibrium curve is an S-shaped curve over the range of partial pressure from 0 to 100 mmHg. Oxyhemoglobin equilibrium curve, a dissociation or association curve, explains the relationship between the partial pressure of oxygen in blood with oxygen saturation hemoglobin. Oxyhemoglobin equilibrium curve is an S-shaped curve over the range of partial pressure of oxygen from 0 to 100 mmHg. The sigmoid shape of the curve results from the oxyhemoglobin. The sigmoid shape of the curve results from hemoglobin affinity for oxygen at various partial pressure of oxygen levels. As partial pressure of oxygen raises, the hemoglobin saturation progressively increases. However, the saturation is not linear with increase in partial pressure of oxygen, for which the curve becomes sigmoid shape. The S-shaped oxyhemoglobin equilibrium curve enables oxygen to saturate hemoglobin under high partial pressures in the lung and to give up large amounts of oxygen with small changes in partial pressure of oxygen at the tissue level. The curve is divided into two major phases, the steep phase and plateau phase. Okay. The sigmoid shape of the curve results from hemoglobin affinity for oxygen at various partial pressure of oxygen levels. As partial pressure of oxygen level rises, the hemoglobin saturation progressively increases. However, the saturation is not linear with increase in partial pressure of oxygen, for which the curve becomes sigmoid. Thus, S-shaped oxyhemoglobin curve enables oxygen to saturate hemoglobin under high partial pressure in the lung and to give up large amount of oxygen with small change in partial pressure at the tissue level. The curve is divided into two major phases, steep phase and plateau phase. Okay. This is the oxyhemoglobin dissociation curve. It is a sigmoid curve. Okay. With increase in partial pressure of oxygen, hemoglobin saturation become high, okay, rises. Steep phase, okay. The curve has a steep slope between the partial pressure of oxygen of 10 and 60 mmHg. During this phase of the curve, combination of oxygen with hemoglobin increases very rapidly as the partial pressure of oxygen increases from 10 to 60 mmHg. Oxygen saturation of hemoglobin is about 90% at partial pressure of oxygen at 60 mmHg. Significance of steep phase. In the steep phase, oxygen saturation of hemoglobin is very high. Less increase in partial pressure of oxygen leads to greater percentage saturation of hemoglobin and therefore facilitates oxygen loading. Also change in steep portion of the curve in reverse direction. That is from 60 to 10 mmHg causes unloading of oxygen in the tissues. A small decrease in partial pressure of oxygen in the tissues results in unloading of the large amount of oxygen to the tissues. The stiff phase allows large quantities of oxygen to be released from hemoglobin in the tissues. Capillaries where a lower capillary partial pressure of oxygen prevails. This is especially achieved by shifting the cow to the right by increasing H plus or by increased CO2. Shift occurs mainly on the stiff phase. Okay. See once again, stiff phase. The cow has a steep slope between partial pressure of oxygen of 10 to 60 mm Hg. Steep slope between partial pressure of oxygen of 10 and 60 mm Hg. See. The partial pressure of oxygen from 10 to 60 mm, it is more steep, okay? Up to the partial pressure of oxygen level from 10 to, here from 10 to 60 mm Hg, we call this as steep phase. The cow has the steep slope between partial pressure of oxygen of 10 and 60 mmHg. During this phase of cow, combination of oxygen with hemoglobin increases very rapidly as the partial pressure of oxygen increases from 10 to 60 mmHg. Oxygen saturation of hemoglobin is about 90% at partial pressure of oxygen 60 mmHg. Significance of stiff phase. In the stiff phase, oxygen saturation of hemoglobin is very high. Less increase in partial pressure leads to greater percentage saturation of hemoglobin and therefore facilitates oxygen loading. Also, change in steep portion of the cow in reverse direction, that is from 60 to 10 mmHg, causes unloading of oxygen in the tissues. A small decrease in partial pressure in tissue results in unloading of large amount of oxygen to the tissues. The stiff phase allows large quantity of oxygen to be released from hemoglobin in the tissue capillaries, where a lower capillary partial pressure of oxygen prevails. This is especially achieved by shifting the cow to right by increasing H plus R by increasing CO2. Okay. Next, plateau phase. The cow begins to plateau at partial pressure around 60 mmHg and flattens at partial pressure of 70 mmHg. The increase in partial pressure of oxygen above 60 mmHg produces only a small increase in oxygen binding. Increase in partial pressure of oxygen from 60 to 100 mmHg in the plateau region of the cow illustrates that oxygen saturation and content remains apparently constant over a wide alteration in alveolar partial pressure of oxygen. Next, significance of plateau phase. There are two significance of plateau phase. In different conditions like, or in different situations like at high altitude or in pulmonary diseases in which a moderate hypoxia, decrease in partial pressure from 95 to 60 mmHg occurs. The total amount of oxygen carried by hemoglobin decreases only by 5 to 10%. Since hemoglobin saturation is about 90% at partial pressure of oxygen of 60 mmHg. Thus, plateau in the cow provides a safety factor through which even a significant decrease in lung function can allow normal saturation of hemoglobin. Oxygen saturation and content remain fairly constant in spite of wide fluctuations in alveolar PO2. For example, if partial pressure of oxygen at alveolum at arterial blood rises from 100 to 120 mmHg, hemoglobin saturation increases only slightly, that is 97% to 98%. This is the reason why oxygen content can't be raised applicably by hyperventilation or by breathing 100% oxygen, because hemoglobin is already completely saturated with oxygen at partial pressure of oxygen of 100 mmHg. This is true only for normal people at sea level. If a person has low arterial partial pressure of oxygen due to lung disease or his ascension to high altitude, hyperventilation or breathing 100% oxygen increases hemoglobin saturation with oxygen, as they have more deoxyhemoglobin initially. If you see this curve from 60 mmHg of partial pressure of oxygen to 100 mmHg of partial pressure of oxygen, we call this phase as plateau phase. Okay, there is only a small amount of change in hemoglobin saturation. Okay, it is from about 90% to 96, 97, and 98. Okay, the 90% of saturation done at 60 mmHg. Okay guys, see it once again. Plateau phase, the curve begins to plateau at partial pressure of oxygen around 60 mmHg and flattens at partial pressure of oxygen at 70 mmHg. The increase in partial pressure above 60 mmHg produces a small increase in oxygen binding. Increase in partial pressure of oxygen from 60 to 100 mmHg in the plateau region of the curve illustrates that oxygen saturation and content remain apparently constant over a wide alteration in alveolar partial pressure of oxygen. Next, coming to the significance of plateau phase. There are two significance of plateau phase in different situations, like at high altitude or in pulmonary diseases in which a moderate hypoxia, decrease in partial pressure of oxygen from 95 to 60 mmHg occurs, the total amount of oxygen carried by hemoglobin decreases only by from 95 to 60. When the partial pressure of oxygen decreases from 95 to 60 mmHg, the total amount of oxygen carried by hemoglobin decreases only by 5 to 10%. Since hemoglobin saturation is about 90% at partial pressure of oxygen or 60 mmHg, this plateau in the curve provides a safety factor through which even a significant decrease in lung function can allow normal saturation of hemoglobin. Oxygen saturation and content remain fairly constant in spite of wide fluctuations in alveolar partial pressure of oxygen. For example, if alveolar partial pressure of oxygen rises from 100 to 120 mmHg, okay, for example, if partial pressure of oxygen in alveoli raises from 100 to 120 mmHg, hemoglobin saturation increases only slightly from 97 to 98 only. This is the reason why oxygen content can't be raised applicably by hyperventilation or by breathing 100% oxygen, because hemoglobin is already completely saturated with oxygen at partial pressure of oxygen of 100 mmHg. This is true only for the normal people at sea level. If a person has low arterial partial pressure of oxygen due to lung disease or his ascension to high altitude, hyperventilation or breathing 100% oxygen increases hemoglobin saturation with oxygen, as they have more deoxyhemoglobin initially. Okay. See, what is P50? Okay. P50 is the level of partial pressure of oxygen at which 50% of hemoglobin is saturated with oxygen. The P50 assesses the binding affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. In adults at sea level, the normal P50 occurs at a partial pressure of oxygen of 27 mmHg. Alteration in the P50 value has a greater impact on the steep face of the curve. If P50 is high, it signifies the decrease in affinity of, if P50 is high, that means a high pressure that is greater than 27 mmHg. Okay. If P50 is high, it signifies the decrease in affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen, which is seen in right shift of the oxyhemoglobin equilibrium curve. Okay. Conversely, if P50 is low, it signifies shift of the curve to the left, in which affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen is more. See this figure. This graph shows the P50 level increases or decreases. Okay, if you see this, this is the normal oxyhemoglobin dissociation curve. This is the normal, okay, about P50. Okay, normal P50 curve. If you see this, this curve shows the shift to the right. Okay, this curve shows the shift to the right. That means increase partial pressure, increase P50. Okay, increase in P50 denotes the decrease affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. Okay, decrease affinity to binding oxygen. Okay, decrease oxygen affinity to hemoglobin. Okay, that means increase P50 denotes. When it's coming to the left shift, okay, this left shift defines that decrease in partial pressure of oxygen, that is P50. Decrease P50 denotes that hemoglobin affinity increases for oxygen. Okay, clear guys? Next, once again, see what is P50. P50 is the level of partial pressure of oxygen at which 50% of hemoglobin is saturated with oxygen. P50 assesses the binding affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen. In adults at sea level, the normal P50 occurs at a partial pressure of oxygen of 27 mmHg. See, if you see here, this is the P50, okay, at partial pressure of oxygen at 27 mmHg. Okay, at 27 mmHg, partial pressure of oxygen for hemoglobin reaches, okay, at 27 mmHg of oxygen, hemoglobin saturation becomes 50. 50% of hemoglobin is saturated at 27 mmHg of oxygen partial pressure. Alteration in the P50 value has the greater impact on the steep phase of the curve. If the P50 is high, it signifies the decrease in affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen, which is seen in right shift of the oxyhemoglobin equilibrium curve. Conversely, if P50 is low, it signifies shift of the curve to the left, in which affinity of hemoglobin for oxygen is more. Okay. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.